Open my blinds.
Sure, opening your blinds.
Hey Google, close the blinds.
Okay, your blinds are now being closed.
Hello and welcome back to another video of CircuitDigest. In this video, I'll show you how you can build an automated blinds using your Arduino. So here we have our setup which we can use to automatically open or close the blinds. Now we can control this either using your mobile phone, that is with the Blink application, or through Google Assistant. Now I'll show you how it works. So this is our Blink application over here. Let me bring it closer. So as you can see, we have options to open the blind, to close the blind, and also we can set a predefined timing. For example, I have set to open the blinds by 10 o'clock every day. You can add multiple timings as required. So now let's start by closing the blinds. If I click on close blinds, you can see that the motor here starts to spin. Now, while this completes the spin, let me quickly show you whatever is present on this board over here. This is nothing much. We are powering it using a 12 volt source. And then we have a small Perf board inside, which converts this 12 volts to 3.3 volts. This 12 volts is used to power the ULN2003 stepper driver module. And the 3.3 volts is used to power the NodeMCU over here. If you take a view at the cross section, you can see that we have our stepper motor over here. And this is the gear wheel, which is used to pull or to open or close the blinds. So I'll show you how the entire thing works shortly. Now I'll also just quickly show you how the open blind thing works. So if I click on open blind, you can see that the motor is now rotating in clockwise. Previously it was rotating in anti-clockwise. So the number of turn it makes is hard coded inside the Arduino code. Now based on the size of the window you have, you might want to change that variable. So this is how the project works. It's very simple. You can control it either through Blink app, or you can also control it using the Google Assistant. I'll also show you how that is done. So let me just, okay, Google, close the blinds. So as you can see, as soon as I give the command, Google Assistant uses the same Blink API to close the blinds. I can also open it using the same command. I can just go like open the blinds.
Sure, opening your blinds.
So as you can see, this is how the project works. Now what I will do is I'll just power this down and remove the components from this board so that I can show in detail what exactly is happening here. Yeah, so what I have done now is that I have just disassembled our board over here. As you can see, this is the NodeMCU and this was the Perf board which I was talking about earlier, and this is the stepper motor, and this is the complete circuit diagram of the setup that you're seeing over here. So it is very simple. We have our barrel jack over here which will be powered by 12 volts, and the LM1117 3.3 volt voltage regulator, which you can see here, is used to convert this 12 volt to 3.3 volt, and this 12 volt is used to power the stepper driver module over here, as you can see, and this 3.3 volts is used to power the NodeMCU. These are just two filtering capacitors to filter out any noise that might occur. Now the reason for using 12 volt is that to pull or open or close the blinds, we need some level of torque. So it is mandatory to use 12 volts to power our stepper motor. I tried it with 5 volts, but there was not enough torque. So I would recommend you using 12 volts. And apart from that, the circuit is very simple. You just have to connect your stepper motor directly to your stepper motor driver module. And you will need 4 pins on your NodeMCU to connect to the 4 input pins of the stepper driver. I have directly soldered these wires. As you can see, these are the four wires. I have directly soldered these pins to the back side of these of this board. That is why you're not able to see anything. If you can see, there is a small gap over here and there are a lot of wires going inside. So these two pins over here gets the 12 volt from the barrel jack directly, and these four pins are connected to these four GPIO pins of the NodeMCU. Now, frankly speaking, the electronics part of this project is very simple. What you have to be careful is with designing the gear. So designing the gear is a bit tricky, but if you have a 3D printer, you can directly download the STL files for these two things and you can print it directly and just assemble it and get it going. Like always, the circuit diagram, the code, the STL files, the build details, everything can be found at the link given in the description of this video. Now, there is one catch here though. There are many types of beadings available. So when I say beadings, I refer to this thread with beads, which is used to close or open your blinds. Let me just bring them closer. Now, the rope that I have here is the most commonly used type of rope. Let me clear these things and I'll show you how it is done. Let me bring in this. Yeah, so if you can see the rope that I have here, the size of this particular beading is like 4 mm diameter, and the distance between these two beadings, that is the center to center distance, is like 6 mm. So if your rope also has the same specifications, then this gear, whose STL can be found at the link, will work very well. You just have to print it, and it also comes with a small hole and an option to add a nut. A screw, so that you can directly fix it on your servo motor like this. And this casing is nothing special. So these two holes over here can be used to mount this whole thing over the wall. And then you can just mount the stepper motor like this. It goes nicely inside this slot. You can just press it here and you can just screw these things. Screw the stepper motor directly into the slot like this. So you can adjust this based on the tension required for your thread. Once you have decided on that, you can just use a screwdriver and secure the stepper motor in position. So this also has a few more slots over here, screw slots, which you can use to secure your motor driver module as well as the NodeMCU board. Now, obviously, if you need, you can also design a PCB which has this regulator along with the NodeMCU board. So this is a very simple board. You won't face any difficulties in building this. Coming to the gear wheel, as I told you earlier, if this is the specifications of your beading, then you can directly print this gear wheel and you'll be good. But if the spacing between the beadings is different, I have seen many other blinds which has a different spacing between two beads. In that case, you would have to design your own gear wheel. Now again, the details given here can also be found at the link given in the description of this video. So it is very simple. Let us say this beads has to be arranged in a fashion like this. So in that case, we already know that the distance between two beadings should be 6 mm and the diameter should be 4 mm. So if we should have 24 beads in this circle, then by using the formula to calculate the circumference, which is a 2 pi r, we can calculate the diameter required for this gear wheel. So if you see, the diameter is about 46 mm and the inner diameter, that is from this end to this end of this gear wheel, is also 46 mm. So this is just a small tip on how you can design your own gear wheels, but most of your beadings should also have this same gap of 6 mm, so it shouldn't be a problem. Just print both these modules, make the connections as per the circuit diagram that I showed earlier, and upload the code given in the link at description and follow the steps over there, and you should be good to go. So that is it guys, this is how you can build this project. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, bye bye.